Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise and exalted and magnified and holy is the name of our Lord Jesus Christ in your life. This is the moment which is solemn, in which you are by yourself and awaiting to receive the Holy Spirit. And I'll tell you one thing. I will try to teach you how you should be from this moment now. I know that everyone has been awaiting for the descent of the Holy Spirit, and I believe with all my heart, with all assurance, that no one than the Holy Spirit and our Lord Jesus desires for you to receive Him, because He wants to dwell within you. This is the greatest desire. God's ambition is to dwell within you. You have no idea of how much He does. Just like a couple, when they desire to have a child, and when this child is born, then the couple are happy because a child is born. A child was born. And the joy from both parents, and only the parents, whoever is a parent, understand the joy it is to know that they brought to this earth a child. They brought a new creature. Do you remember that day? Do you remember when you had your child and the nurse brought you your child into your arms, so innocent, pure? Very well. You had joy because a child was born from you. And this is what God feels. This is God's feeling towards all of us. When the Holy Spirit descends upon a person, He forms a new person. And this is what the Holy Scripture says. This is what is written. This is what happened when Jesus, He was conceived in Virgin Mary. The Bible says that an angel spoke to Mary these words. And when the angel answered, telling Mary, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you." I have goosebumps. I have goosebumps right now. "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," hallelujah, "and the power of the highest," hallelujah, "will overshadow you," hallelujah, hallelujah. This is what's going to happen with you right now. I have goosebumps right now as I say this, from the top of my head to my toes, because I have this assurance that this is what's going to happen. Therefore, also, the Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God. So you will be made holy, and you will be called a child of God. Because a child of God, there's no sex, is a child of God. Spirit does not have a sex. It has, whether man, woman, boy or girl, is a child of God. So you will be holy, a holy child of God, when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And then You will have joy. You will have pleasure from the moment in which you receive the Holy Spirit. May problems, injustice, bad mouth, persecution, any evil, everything that this world can offer that is bad, evil, may come against you, but those who have the Holy Spirit will remain forever. Hallelujah. Because it's the living God inside of you. It is the living God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, the God of Jacob, is what Jesus said to the Jews who were religious and hypocrite. And Jesus told them, saying, God is not the God of the dead, but he's the God of the living. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, they are alive. Why so? Because the Most High came with them, upon them, guiding them. And now he wants to dwell inside of you. Very well. You have the assurance of this. And the Bible also says that fulfilling the day of Pentecost, they were all together. They were in the same place on the day of Pentecost. They were all together. We are all together in the same place before God. I am with you and you are with me. And we are in one place. We are in spirit, in one place, agreeing in the same faith, with the same purpose. Acts chapter 2, verse 1 says, fulfilling the day of Pentecost, when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place, same place, agreeing together. Because no one is right now together with us that is not in the same spirit, awaiting for the descent of the Holy Spirit. Everyone is in accord, in one spirit. We had agreed to be together. And what I want is to explain to you, what will you do for the Holy Spirit to come upon you right there where you are? Pay attention. I know many say, Bishop, I've done this. I've made sacrifices, fasting of Daniel. I did everything that I knew of. Everything. And I did not receive the Holy Spirit as of yet. There is one thing that you have not yet done, which was to place out of you, to remove from within you everything that is hidden, 100%, to let go of grudges. You have problems that are deep, that you are carrying deep inside of you, sins that only you and God know of. And you will need to bring it out, pour it out before God. You're not going to tell this to no one, if not to God at this moment. You are alone, right? So then you can share, you can speak, because nobody will hear you. It's in the middle of the night. It's a moment where you are by yourself. It's a moment that God is before you. The Holy Spirit is right there. And he is waiting for you to empty of yourself from everything you have been carrying within. We are going to give you minutes for you to do so. You will pour out. You will pour out everything that you have kept inside of your heart that is hidden, you're going to bring it out. Leave nothing behind. Do not hide anything. You will empty yourself. And when you empty yourself, then the Holy Spirit will fill you. The Holy Spirit will come and occupy that place. That's what's going to happen. Is it clear now? So everything that is within you, you will pour it out. Remove all the trash that you have been carrying throughout these years, even inside of the church. Even being in the church, you have been carrying this space that is that belongs to the Holy Spirit. You will remove it right now in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. You do not need to pray. You don't need to say, oh God, my Jesus, nothing. Just tell him, Lord, I know you are here. You believe that he's there? So speak to him what is inside of you. Remove all this garbage that is inside of you, and I will give you time for you to do so that we can all be cleansed, clean for the Holy Spirit to come. So speak to God now. Our God and our Father, and you see each and every one, you can see them, and you see their sincerity. None of us deserve nothing from you. We do not deserve no blessing, favor, or grace, much less to receive your presence or the shadow of your spirit in our lives. But it is promised. You said you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witness, my Father. You see that even though we do not have any merits, yet we have faith. And through this faith that you hear our prayer, this certainty and assurance that you are here in this moment as you are with me, just as you are with this person wherever they are. You are with them because you are omniscient and you know it all. You are omnipotent because you have all the power in the heaven and on earth and in everything that exists. And you are, my God, omnipresent because you are in all places and you are here with us in this very moment, and you see this person's sincerity. You are watching this person that is pouring out all the filthiness that they have been carrying within, all the grudges, resentment, removing from within them everything they did wrong, absolutely everything, cleaning themselves, making right now a total cleansing within, from inside out, from inside of their soul, their heart. And because of this action, because of this faith, at this hour that we have selected, and an hour that they, it is an hour in which they could be resting, they could be sleeping, because it is in the middle of the night. And this sacrifice, O Lord, shows and it proves and gives you sign of faith. And this faith pleases you. It is not our merits because we have none, but we have faith. Faith upon your word, faith in your promises, that you, O Lord, that you want to fill them with your spirit, so that your name be sanctified in the life of each and everyone throughout this world. They will be witness that you spoken of your word. You said you will receive power. You will receive power, and you will be my witness, not witness only to speak of you. No, Lord, because to speak is easy. Anyone can speak of you. Any sinner can speak of you. Any professor, any unbeliever can speak of you. But to be witness of you requires a divine character. It requires the character of our Lord Jesus, a character of good, of wanting to do good to others, not only to their loved ones alone or family members, because that is selfishness, but to want good to everyone, even good to be done to the enemies, O living God of Israel. For us to be living witness of your spirit, not only at home, but also in any given place that we may go, we need, my Lord, your spirit. We need your character, of your way of being, of your greatness and compassion and love and mercy and forgiveness, consideration, justice, truth. O living God of Israel, as I am speaking to you, Lord, come upon your people now. Descend upon your people, upon all the people right now. Honor your word, my Lord. Honor your word, so that your word, through this person, may honor your name throughout this world, sanctifying your holy name, my Lord. Oh, I ask, O Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, let there be light in this moment. Let there be the outpouring pouring of your Spirit. The world needs to see that you are living God, that you are the living God, that you are together with those who call upon you in spirit and in truth and sincerity. Oh, my Lord, come upon your people and make them, Father, to have, my Lord, this spirit, your spirit coming upon them, with those, my Lord, who want to serve you, to do your will, and they want, my Lord, to spread throughout this world your salvation. So pour upon them, pour your spirit upon them in this very moment, right now, Father. This is what I ask, together with all your people from north, south, east, west, wherever there is someone in this planet calling upon you right now in this very hour, be filled with your spirit so that your name be glorified and sanctified and your kingdom, Lord, may be spread throughout this world, through this person, and finally, your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. Oh, I ask you, O Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, I know that this is the Father, the will of the Father and of the Holy Spirit, and that's why I'm here. That's why we are here. So let your will be done in these people right now, in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And you who believe, you say amen. And praise God. Glorify Him. Adore Him. Yes. Let the joy of the Holy Spirit, His Spirit takes over you. The joy of the Holy Spirit comes because you receive peace. You receive forgiveness. And because of this, you are cleansed. You are purified before the Most High. And because of His forgiveness towards you, so you have peace now. Receive peace. This is the Holy Spirit. The peace is the mark, is God's stamp, seal upon you. Because the wicked, they don't have peace. The sinners do not have peace. But those who have God's Spirit, those who have the Spirit of peace, they are in peace. And not only peace, but they also have the joy of the Holy Spirit. So be joyful right now, because God is with you as He is with me. And this happens right now. As you adore Him, so give Him thanks. Right now, you can raise your hands up to heaven. If you can't, stand up and raise your hands as highest as you can and worship Him, praise Him with all your heart. Yes, you can share, you can speak to Him now what you never spoke, and you can say to Him, I love you. Now I know what it is to love Him above all things, because right now you love the Lord above all things, above everyone, above everything, more than your family members, more than your loved ones, more than your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your fiance, more than your family. You love Him more than anything, your properties, assets, everything that you possess. You love Him above all things. And He's the greatest thing that you have. And He teaches you how to love our Lord Jesus as how He should be loved in spirit and in truth. And above all, you put Him first. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Be filled with the Holy Spirit. Become happy from today on. Have a new life from this moment on. Have a different life from everything you have been living up until now. Be renewed in your faith, revived. You had the Holy Spirit, but you were weak. You were cold, but right now, you are no longer cold because the Holy Spirit raises you up. He lifts you up. He lifts those who are fallen and He brings joy. He brings joy to all with His peace in Jesus' name. Praise be God to God. Blessed is the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And let me tell you this. Before I speak, I will not interrupt as you are worshiping. We are going to play a song, a hymn, and as long as they are singing this hymn, glorify Him, because I have a special message for you. I'll show to you the sign that the Holy Spirit is within you. You will know how to know that you have been baptized with the Holy Spirit. We're going to listen to this song, but you can continue worshiping Him wherever you are.
Breathe, Holy Spirit. Lift up the fallen. Carry and cure the pain. Calling out for your name. Come to restore. Breathe, Holy Spirit. Wash us with life. Mend back the pieces. I can hear noises of your great work. Make Christ from out of the valley. Every dry bone must be lifted, and with your power, come and restore. Dip from amongst the fallen, bring up a mighty nation to walk through the earth when the wind. Tribal.
praise God at any place in this planet where you are, know this, there is a universal church. You can be sure of it. Search and you will find. Even on the internet, you have the addresses to find. But what I want to share with you, what is the sign? What is the sign of the baptism with the Holy Spirit? Is it speaking tongues, Bishop? No. I was baptized with the Holy Spirit, and I did not speak in tongues that day. And throughout some time, I did not speak in tongues. I only came to speak in tongues months later. So do not be worried about speaking tongues. But if you speak in tongues and you don't have peace, then you should be worried. Because if a person speaks in tongue, but they don't have peace, then these tongues are not of God. That's why we never should associate the baptism with the Holy Spirit with the speaking of tongues, because the devil speaks so. The devil prophesy. He does a mess to fool people who do not know the word. That's why Wednesday is the day for you to learn and meditate and study the word of God so that you can have your faith in an intelligent way, a faith with wisdom, a faith that is based upon the word of God. So the sign, the main sign of the baptism with the Holy Spirit is your inner peace. Is this inner peace? I'm not saying that you're going to have peace at work or around your family. No, this peace I cannot guarantee, but I can guarantee that inside of you, you have peace. And when you have peace within you and with God, then you have a mind to be able to think. You are able to make the choices that are right according to the Holy Scriptures. And that's what intelligent faith is, a faith that is intelligent. So this inner peace is the sign, the very first sign that a person received the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of peace. The Holy Spirit is the peace, Spirit of peace. Jesus, when he was baptized in water, he received the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit took him to the desert to face the devil. But the Holy Spirit strengthened him, did not leave him alone. And Jesus overcame the temptations, overcame the devil in the desert. So then, peace comes from the Holy Spirit. And why peace comes? Because once a person has been forgiven of their sins, they are no longer guilty before God. And the devil cannot accuse you anymore because they have been forgiven. Until yesterday, you were living a life of prostitution or lies or theft. But from now on, you are no longer going to sell your body. You will no longer be able to lie. You will no longer live a wrong life because now you have peace. And the guidance of the Holy Spirit will give you conscience, a clean conscience that is pure and inside of you, this is what happens. Those of you who receive the Holy Spirit, this happens within you. So the first sign is peace. And what is the following sign? Once they are peaceful, they have joy. And then, although the world is at war, Everything is falling around them, collapsing, but they are in peace and they have joy because they have been chosen by God. You have been chosen by God. And being chosen by God, obviously, the devil cannot touch those who are of God, as it is written in the scripture, the devil cannot touch. So, all the wars around us, these will remain until the end. But within us, there is peace. There is peace. And this peace brings joy, pleasure, for you to be well with yourself, and above all, with God, wherever you are going to be well. And the Lord Jesus gives us the Holy Spirit, not to give us peace alone and to make us joyful, but also to give us condition and power to also spread of His resurrection. Because only those who have God's Spirit, only those who have the Spirit who resurrected our Lord Jesus, they have the power to spread about Jesus being alive. They are witness. And this is the testimony. The way that I testify about Him is because His Spirit is within me and I have the power. I have the power to shout out to everyone to say that Jesus is alive. Our Savior is alive, and I'm ready to save all those who call upon Him. Everyone. It doesn't matter their religion, but if this person confesses the Lord Jesus and believes that He is alive, then this person also can receive His Spirit and receive the life and joy and peace above all things, because everyone has this right. Regardless of their religion. Is it clear? So then, I'll say it again. The first sign of God's presence, of His Spirit, of the baptism of the Holy Spirit, the seal of God in us, and He confirms this inside of you, I'm sure of it, is the peace. And right after comes joy. The joy of salvation, and you are free from all accusation. The devil has nothing on you because you are free. You are no longer serving the father of lies to serve now the father of truth. And the father of truth is within you. Hallelujah. Praise God. So may God bless all of you. We are coming to the end. But I would like for you to go on the social network of the Universal Church. You can go to my Instagram. You can post and say, I received the Holy Spirit. This is what happened. You can share. So you can let other people know that our Lord Jesus is alive and that He fulfills His word to those that seek Him in spirit and in truth. Because to seek God in the middle of the night, it is something only for the few. Normally, people in the middle of the night, they are after the party. They are dancing. They are there doing drugs, whatever. You know. But those who are of God, those who have been chosen, they are seeking the Most High, and they receive His Spirit. So He has fulfilled His promise for you. We are coming to the end, and until tomorrow, in Jesus' name, God bless all of you. Amen, and praise God.